actually that letter.
I saw even this week.
That's the plumbing checks, and it goes above the top.
Extra one of them, I think they gave it out last time.
Tumbling those skin.
Thank you.
Six.
We've edited and worked on this all the way to ordinance, and I think we have worked with legal, and I think we've made all the changes that we discussed in previous settings, and so we're just here to review the changes that were suggested before moving forward with this. There was some verbiage taken out. And fee set in structure that we discussed last time. Some of the verbiage that was removed is the original ordinance required that the waste hauler pass the fee on to the customer. And those were taken out because how they did it. They don't have to pass it on or can pass however much they want to. So that kind of changed quite a bit of the verbiage in looking at ordinance about. Nothing has been changed necessarily that we didn't, that was not discussed here.
And the recycling is optional. They get a deduction off the franchise fee.
Give it off.
There was a little bit of verbiage put in there requiring that when they place things by the curb, that they make sure that the customer knows not to put it in such a way to go in storm drains and such.
But just compared to most other counties, Jordan County's solid waste plant?
Ours is actually pretty lax, but at the same time, we've never had an ordinance before. So I think starting with this, because to go full blown would be just.
Now, in a fee structure, you can go down to 1.5%.
Right,
that's
exactly.
Okay. Just three stops,
and
go down to one
night. And we're not really mandating. It's pretty typical for counties that do not haul their own ways to have some sort of fee, some sort of franchise for their services. I don't know really of one that doesn't, unless they haul their own ways.
Okay, so if we can review my benefit, please.
Yes.
We're proposing here a 3% increase, or 3%, 5%.
No.
Just a 5% fee.
Yeah.
Franchise fee.
We're calling it an infrastructure fee, because we're not really putting anything out for bid. It's simply, if you want to haul waste in the county, then you have to adhere to this contract. And it's a 5% fee. You find that.
Yeah.
On page 9.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes. And then you get a one.
Actually, you get 2% discount.
2% discount if you are seated in the county and qualify as a county business, paid county taxes, applicable form and such.
Now, that 5% would then go to a 3% total.
Right, 2% reduction for a 3% fee.
Yes.
So it can also go lower.
Yes.
And then you get a 0.5% reduction if you take the waste you collect in the county to Eagle Point Landfill. And you get an additional 1% if you offer recycling.
Would it be easier to take that high down to 1? Would it be easier to calculate on like down to 1%? Just if I mess 1 to high?
It would be. The issue there is then you have just almost a monopoly of a couple of companies who are not paying anything, who actually end up being our biggest customers.
You don't mind it being 0.5%?
You don't mind as far as calculation wise.
It's just the number.
What worries me, and it's just from talking to other, it is, we don't want to create a situation where there is some sort of monopoly, because the whole idea behind this is to still have an open market system. And so.
Well, it's to capture funds from companies that are not headquartered here, that come in, collect waste, take it to another landfill, and got those heavy trucks beating up our roads.
Well, ultimately, we're, whether they take it to our landfill or not, that frequently, we're going to eventually get that hose bid. It's just going to be spread out over a long time.
They could take it out of camp, too, like pull the camp or something.
Well, unfortunately, I don't think a 100% is going to change that, because that particular company is usually based out of a landfill. So they're going to pay that fee regardless.
But that kind of makes up for the hose fee that we're not getting, that helps offset the infrastructure cost.
And we're filling up our landfill quicker.
And they go on about their business, and we're done. Get those trucks off the road all again.
That's good.
This, to me, this seems, it seems high somehow.
What, 5% or?
Yeah, starting at 5%. Has anybody, have any, you think that there are three or four or five haulers who have heard about this and had a chance to react, talk to you about it at all?
I know at least four have, because I've gotten letters and references.
What do they say?
To it. A couple of the smaller haulers had questions. I think at the most of it is simply because they haven't gotten facts at this point, because it was just hearsay what was in the newspaper.
But this is a million, this is a minimum of a 1.5% increase for everybody, right?
Yeah, there was some talk about some of the smaller haulers that, what do you call it, go behind the house, what do they call it?
Drive pickup, curbside or doorside.
You know,
back door.
That they were going to be harmed, and then somebody started rumoring there was going to be a landfill, land or recycling center or something. So none of that's.
Instead of a horse park.
Instead of a horse park, they're telling everybody it's going to be a landfill.
But what are we using the 1.5% for?
It's actually, the whole idea behind this is to pay for, essentially, we have these companies coming in hauling waste and really benefiting from a service that a lot of counties provide themselves. So they're coming in and
but now remember, even in county, people are paying the 1.5%. Right?
Right.
So everybody is paying a minimum of the 1.5%. And where's the 1.5% going?
It's going to maintenance and infrastructure fee, which would be engineering, assumably. It's spelled out in here. Let's see, fees paid.
Where I'm going with this is, you know, I could maybe see this if it was fixing, going into the roads, because, you know, trucks in general tear things up and they're going all the way to Eagle Point. But the county's getting a buck per ton on the waste anyway. We're sort of giving the locals a little bit of an advantage over ones that are out of the county. I just don't know why, what the 1.5% is really getting the county.
It is going into the roads, because when I say infrastructure, that's what is spelled out in here, is it's going to road maintenance, it's going to solid waste. What page are you coming down on?
It's on page 3, I think.
It's actually spelled out in two places.
How much do you expect to bring in, do any calculations then?
I really have no clue at this point, because that's the other thing, is I have no numbers to base this on. That was the biggest part of this ordinance, was the recycling and the numbers. The fee was something that was suggested actually by the commission.
We don't have any way of knowing the total tonnage of solid waste, but this is designed to promote recycling, to promote education, to help offset the expenses of the post-closure of the current landfill. And those are things that we currently that the current solid waste fees are going to. So this is in addition to those fees that we've left.
Dedicated revenue. The infrastructure maintenance will be collected by the county, page 11. Under this article shall be dedicated to the following: maintenance of the county streets, corridors, alleys, thoroughfares, and transportation routes, administration of contract compliance between customers and companies where services received as provided in this article, and collection of litter and trash within the county. I do believe there was another.
Would this go like into an itemized fund, is that your belief, or would this go into general fund?
That would be up to the commission.
Well, that's just.
Well, this would be a dedicated revenue.
Yeah, okay. So we'd have line items.
Right, and at this point, I would anticipate it going into a special revenue fund. Yes, there'd be a line of control.
There's actually, right, two or three divisions of this fund is more than obvious. One and a half against everybody, 1% if they offer recycling, and 0.5, if they take a legal. So are those three separate funds or one fund?
You know, this equates to just my bill's $15 a month.
How much are you going to be? It'll be less than 0.75. 10 cents, 15 cents. 5 cents, 7 cents. 7 cents.
7 cents.
7 cents.
Can I get a copy of this budget?
You won't get 10 cents.
Well, down to 1.5.
Yeah, 1.5.
And the other thing is, since we're not mandating recycling, this scale is very similar to the structure we have at recycling centers by encouraging people to recycle versus some kind of a scale difference. Without mandating recycling, without having some kind of fee or something to change, there is no incentive left for recycling unless you mandate it.
Are you pleased with this? You think it's a good?
I think it's a good start. I don't expect it to be a huge revenue generator, but that wasn't, I don't think, the purpose. The intent was to get something in place to build if we need, or this may get in place and be, you know, completely give me the numbers I need and everything looks great.
And they encourage recycling.
To answer the commissioner's question, I think it's still one source, it's several different measurements of one source. So I anticipate it being one restricted revenue. Whether they're paying 1.5 or
3%. Yes, it's the same source.
Just different measurements of the same purpose.
And I will say, because I don't want to mislead you, there's two references to where the fees will go in here. And the one that we were just looking at only lists three. And there should have actually been a fourth in the other area in here. I'm sure there is a fourth. And it actually allocates a fourth place for the fund to go to. Forsyth County Beautiful or Solid Waste Education and Outreach, which Forsyth County Beautiful does the litter anyway. But there is two separate sections that have that same funding, and that one is just a never, ever. That's what I'm trying to
find. I have one question though. I have a question, because these are different purposes. In that series on page 11, as the county attorney, it uses the word and.
Yep.
Does that mean we have to come up with some way of dividing it among these three purposes, or do we have discretion? Does the board have discretion when they appropriate the dollars for a particular purpose?
They have discretion.
Okay, so it can go off to one purpose or the other.
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Or would tell me, that's, yeah, I don't know if I change the wording or not.
And let's see.
And here we pirate the same from some high dollar city down before we met them.
Running well down there, I might add.
Do we want to make that change, Council?
We can. It's fine. And you can't hurt with and or.
So, but Mr. Chairman, if I could, I would make that as part of the motion, that we approve this as presented with the change in section five, Forsyth.
11.
Dash 75, page 11.
Yep.
Where it talks about dedicated revenue, it says and/or.
Yep.
You make that change and move forward.
Second.
And just for clarification, this is to get to legal hearings?
Yeah, go to public hearings.
Get to public hearings.
Legal. Legal hearings.
Public hearings.
Legal.
They must call.
Legal ads for public hearings.
They must call legal hearings in Tennessee, or Oodle-A or something, wherever it's from.
We have a motion and a second. If there's no further discussion, please vote on the motion. All those in favor signify by saying aye.
Aye.
All those opposed, like sign. That passes 4-0. The commissioner then being absent.